Welcome back, everybody. On deck today for review, we're going over the White Sound Defense flash suppressor. You guys have seen this on the channel for a long time now, really months. I've been meaning to get around to the review, I just haven't gotten to it, but it's an excellent flash suppressor, as you'll see coming up during some nighttime fire. And fit and finish are great, really. I have a lot of time behind it. I really like it. I'll tell you that up front. And we'll get into some of the details, both the pros and the cons, because there are some cons, as there are to most products out there, coming up next. But for now, we're just going to keep putting some rounds down range and see how it performs. We got the White Sound Defense flash hider on there, and we'll see what we get in these low light conditions. It is clear down range. Not bad at all.
I pulled the muzzle device off the rifle so we can get a closer look at it, and I have it angled like this so you can see how it works. First up, it is a timed muzzle device, so this larger piece right here is designed to go at the 6 o'clock position on your rifle. These ports here direct a little bit of the gas sideways, as well as the top here, directing it up, keeping your muzzle on track. Now, if you look here at the side, if you look closely, you'll notice that the gap here in the front is a little bit smaller than the gap here in the rear. They say it's about a 25% difference in the actual size of the gap from back to front. And what that does is, if you look at, say, like a linear compensator, the gas is being push straight forward, which directs energy back into your shoulder. So what that's going to do is prevent it from being driven straight forward and having a little bit of the gas escape on the sides a little bit more due to the pressure there. So that acts somewhat as a brake. That said, primarily, in my opinion, this is primarily a flash hider. It does a little bit of better job than most flash hiders in terms of controlling muzzle rise, but primarily I do view it as a flash hider. As you guys saw earlier in the video, it performs very well in that role. Now, the finish on this one here is a nitrided finish. Now, that's a very good thing, because throughout the review, obviously, we've been using it on a 5.45 rifle, and I've shot predominantly 7.6 ammo out of the rifle, which is obviously corrosive. And as you see here, there are no signs of rust, no signs of corrosion on the muzzle device at all. So it's definitely done a good job of holding up. That nitride finish, though, is an extra $10. And while we're talking about that, let's talk about price. It does retail for $100 for the standard parkerized finish version and $110 for the nitrided version. During the video, you may or may not have noticed that there is no annoying ping sound or ringing sound that comes out of this flash hider. Now, a lot of you guys are familiar with the AAC flash hider, which is also a prong style flash hider, and that thing has an extremely annoying ping or ringing noise every time you fire around. It does work extremely well, but that ringing does just drive a lot of people nuts. So, something to point out there. Another thing to point out is that if you are someone who works on a team, maybe entering and clearing buildings, or if you're just a homeowner and you want to minimize the amount of blast that you might have should you use the weapon in a home defense type of scenario, there's no increased blast from this at all over the A2. In fact, it may be actually a little bit less than the A2, which is saying something. So you are going to get a little bit of reduction in your muzzle rise, but you're not going to get any increased blast, so that's always nice. It's a nice bonus, if you will, but like I said, I do consider this primary a flash hider. But all in all, it works extremely well when you're firing down from the prone. That larger piece on the bottom keeps the dust from kicking back in your face. As you saw, very good flash suppression. It is priced on the higher end of products that are flash hiders out there, no getting around it, but it works well. So sometimes you get what you pay for. Whether or not it's worth it to you is a decision that you guys are ultimately going to have to make at the end of the day. But as always, guys, if you have any questions about this review, anything else I talk about here on the channel, feel free to post below in the comments section. You can also post over at my Facebook page. But thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. If you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe. And I hope to see you guys in the next video.